Welcome to this session on AES 256-bit encryption and decryption. Our approach is to learn by practicing. We therefore recommend that you download AES 256-encrdecr.xlsx from the link given in the description part. Please also download nist.fips.197.pdf from csrc.nist.gov/publications/fips listed under number 197. Our Excel book uses the sample case given in the appendices C of that PDF. It would therefore become much easier for you to follow our workings and also validate the results with those given in the document. We recommend that you view our AES key expansion and AES 128-bit encryption and decryption video before continuing with this session. The link to those videos are given below in the description part. AES 256 encryption and decryption. We will use AES 256-encrdecr.xlsx workbook and refer to Appendix C on page 42 of nist.fips.197.pdf. AES 256-bit encryption consists of 14 iterations. We also have an initial XOR operation of the key with the plain text. That makes the number of wrong keys required to 15. AES 256-bit encryption and decryption is not much different from AES 128-bit other than the above mentioned 4 more rounds of encryption and decryption. The key generation is slightly different from 128-bit key expansion. The key related aspects are covered in our AES key expansion. We have carried the ciphertext and the decrypted plain text to the summary sheet under cell range AJ3 to AY3. And AJ4 to AY4 respectively. If you wish to decrypt your own ciphertext, then enter it in cell range B5 to Q5. The encryption key should also be entered if it is different. Set the toggle cell value to 1, then you will get the plain text in cell range AJ4 to AY4. You may now experiment with various keys and plain text to get a firm grip on the AES 256-bit encryption and decryption algorithm. Thank you. We'll meet again in another session on the mathematical context of AES. Bye. Until then.